What's going on, guys? So one of my first videos, I showed how to order an array of names in order by last name. And then someone commented with a good question. They asked, what if there are multiples of the same last name? In which case, it would just put those last names next to each other and it would still order the array by last name. But to take it a step further, you might want to check the first name and then if the last names are the same, then go by the first name. So that'll require an extra step, and I'll show you how to do that here. So we have this array of names. We have the same last name a couple times, but with different first names. And then Eric Clapton over here, which of course should come first. So we'll be using the sort method, which will actually change the order of the original array. So what we're going to do is make another variable called ordered names. And then we'll just use the spread operator and bring in names, creating a copy of this array. And then we'll call sort on that. We'll have two arguments, name one, name two. So as the sort method iterates over the array, it will compare these strings together and figure out which ones should be placed where. And so these are just placeholders for the different names that it will be comparing. And then you pass in a function on how you want it to compare those names. So we'll use the split method to separate the string into two different strings so that we can access the last name. We'll just say split name one, and that'll be name one, a split method, and then you send in to that split method a string on where you want the string that you're passing in to be separated by. So for us, that will be a space. So it'll split it at the space and give us an array with two items, the first being the first name and the second being the last name. So we'll do that to the second name that it's iterating over as well. We'll call that split name two. That'll be name two. We'll split that and we'll split it at the space. Now we'll create a string where we put the last name first and then the first name, and then we'll compare those. So we'll call it name for sort, because this is just for the sort method. Name for sort one, and we'll do the backticks so that we can use template literals. We'll put in a variable here. Split name one, and then that'll be the second item in the array because it's zero indexed, so that's the last name. And we'll do a space, and we'll do split name one, zero, which is the first name. So that's the first name that it's iterating over, where we put the last name first and then the first, and then we'll do it with the second name as well. We'll call that name for sort two. And then we'll do split name two, access the last name, do a space, split name two, and access the first name. And now we will just return from this sort method name for sort one dot locale compare, which you call that on a string and then send in another string, and it will return a number. It'll be a positive number or a negative number or zero, depending on if it's alphabetically ahead or behind or equal to the string that you're passing in. So we have name for sort one, which is the last name and first name of name one, and we want to compare that to the full name of name two. Name for sort two. And we'll just console.log ordered names, save that. And it should be Eric Clapton, and then the Alan Flanders, and then Shred Flanders. And we'll run this with node names.js, the name of this file. And we get Eric Clapton, Alan Flanders, and then Shred Flanders. So that's how you would order an array of names if you wanted to take the first name into account. And then, of course, you could like and subscribe if you wanted to. Just kidding. I mean, unless you want to.
Either way, it's fine.
Okay, I should stop. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Check it.